Hey, 42 here. You've seen stalking in movies and on TV, but unless you've had an obvious stalking experience, most of you will probably think that it's something that never happens to you. We think that stalking is something that only happens to other people. But there's a good chance that you've been a victim of stalking. In most cases, however, you will never be able to know for sure. The internet and social media make stalking so easy for the stalker, yet so difficult to identify for the victim. Over 7 million people are stalked in the US each year. But how does a stalker manipulate their prey? What drives them to stalk in the first place? Let's step inside the mind of a stalker and uncover some disturbing psychology. The vast majority of stalking, roughly 80%, is domestic stalking, meaning the perpetrator is someone the victim knows, a friend, family, or most commonly, an ex-partner. Stalking can sometimes be mild or just very well concealed, and thus most stalking victims don't actually realize they've been stalked. If you want to assess whether or not you've ever been stalked, simply ask yourself, have you ever received an unwanted gift? Or perhaps a series of strange phone calls or anonymous mail, then you've probably been stalked. In domestic stalking cases involving ex-partners, the obsessive behavior usually begins following a breakup, as I'm sure you probably already know. But what's quite interesting is the psychological process that the man or woman in question goes through to begin stalking the other. Stalkers following a breakup often report a feeling very similar to the grief felt after the death of a loved one. Stalking usually begins when one person attempts to keep in contact with the ex and they don't reciprocate or straight up ignore them. Therefore, they feel as though that person is forever lost to them, similar to a death. The grief this causes can, in some people, trigger a panic response. Many stalkers actually equate it to being remarkably similar to a panic attack. This panic causes them to become obsessed about trying everything they can to re-establish that lost channel of communication. And when you get people with a borderline personality disorder, which is typically diagnosed in around 2% of the population, you have a recipe for disaster. Because such people will take that obsession to anywhere it needs to go to achieve the goal of gaining their ex's attention once again, even if that involves acts of extreme violence. Unlike stranger stalkers, who we'll talk about in just a moment, domestic stalkers tend to act out impulsively instead of in a premeditated manner. Impulsive behavior, however, is usually far more dangerous. You can identify when an ex's obsession with you has crossed over into dangerous territory by examining the current state of their life. You see, as a domestic stalker's obsession levels increase, the rest of their life falls apart around them. It's consistent in stalking cases for the stalker to lose their job as a result of their obsession, and they will also stop eating and sleeping. What makes domestic stalkers so dangerous is that they truly believe that they are the victim. Here's the thing. A domestic stalker never thinks they are a stalker. Consequently, you can never stop a stalker by calling them out on it and saying, "You're a stalker, so please stop stalking me." It's only likely to make the problem worse because they will feel more victimized. Whether they actually are the victim or not depends on the circumstances of each individual case. But the stalker will believe that they are the victim of being closed out of their life, perhaps their home. A very common stereotypical scenario is when a mother gains sole custody of the children, completely shutting out the father from their lives. Rightly or wrongly so, mothers win 90% of custody battles. I'm not trying to justify stalking behavior at all, but it's easy to appreciate how, in those instances, the man will always feel as though he is the victim of a heinous crime, regardless of the events that may have led up to that custody order. The more that the man or woman has been hurt, then the more likely they are to feel victimized, and thus the more likely they are to lash out. Because the stalker is usually in the mindset of, if I'm suffering, then so should you, which can lead to tragic consequences. Anonymous stalkers, on the other hand, are not inspired by a personal connection to the victim, because they don't have one, of course. Stranger stalkers are often the most mentally deranged, i.e. they are more likely to have sociopathic tendencies than domestic stalkers, yet they are surprisingly the least dangerous form of stalker. A typical stranger stalker fits perfectly into the sociopath profile. They are usually highly narcissistic and can easily become obsessed with a particular thing or person. A stranger stalker will begin stalking to gain control, because a typical stalker will have, or at least feel, that they have little control over their own life, either as a result of current circumstance or their upbringing. The behavior of a stalker can seem counterintuitive at first glance. They appear to be obsessed with a particular man or woman, usually sexually, yet they simultaneously go out of their way to intimidate that person or even resort to violence. But there is reasoning behind the aggression. Aggressive behavior is the easiest way to assert control over a victim, especially one that is physically weaker than oneself. Through intimidation, whether that be leaving creepy messages on the victim's answering machine or following them around, the stalker is creating fear and thus asserting control. It stands to reason that the more victims a stalker has under their tyrannical thumb, the more control they feel and enjoy. And this is reflected in the fact that most stranger stalkers do in fact maintain more than one victim at the same time. Interestingly, it's also this desire for control that means that most threats from an anonymous stalker are empty. If, for example, a stalker threatens to kill their victim, most of the time, it is just an extreme way to cause fear and thus gain a greater sense of control over that person. If they were to actually carry through with the murder, they would of course no longer have someone to control, and so that avenue of pleasure would be permanently closed off to them. Obviously, this is not always the case, and there have been many tragic incidents where such threats do turn out to be more than just words. It should also be mentioned that statistically, when a domestic stalker threatens violence against their victim, they are significantly more likely to carry through with it than when a stranger stalker does. Because domestic stalkers are driven more by emotions and a desire for revenge than a need for control, so they are usually more willing to act out violence. According to statistics published in a 2009 paper, domestic stalkers will carry through with a threat of violence 1 out of every 2 times. Whereas a stranger stalker who has no prior relationship with the victim will only carry through with a threat 1 out of every 10 times. These days, of course, there is a new breed of stalking that makes finding out what your victim had for breakfast disturbingly simple: social media. In a world where publicly flaunting which gym you attend each morning and Instagramming scenic pictures of the park you jog through during your daily commute, it's effortless for stalkers to ply their trade. Anyone can be the victim of online stalking and abuse, both men and women. In fact, a recent report by British think tank Demos suggests that men receive much more, with 2.5% of the tweets sent to men being classified as abusive, compared to 1% of tweets directed towards females. Some social media platforms offer tools for you to block certain people from viewing your profile, but these are often woefully inadequate and wouldn't prevent any stalker with a moderate level of IT competency from finding another way to view your latest posts. Honestly, the best thing you can do to protect yourself from unwelcome prying eyes, short of deleting your social media, is making sure your accounts are secure, especially your email account, which is your single point of failure. Recently, 30 million Facebook accounts were compromised, and each month millions more are accessed unwillingly, sometimes unknowingly, by those who wish to do you harm. either socially or financially. The best way to protect yourself is with the leading password manager and all-in-one security suite, Dashlane, who will store all of your passwords in a super safe way without ever having access to them or allowing anyone but you to view them. Dashlane creates strong and unique passwords for all of your online accounts and auto-fills them so you never have to click Forgot Password ever again. And you don't have to sweat about the extremely rare chance that Dashlane could be breached, because Dashlane safely stores and decrypts your data on your local device only, using your master password. This means that Dashlane never has access to your personal data, and any hacker would only see random noise. Dashlane also auto-fills your credit card information whilst online shopping, so you can make purchases without having to fetch your wallet. Dashlane has a built-in VPN to encrypt your data and keep your online activity anonymous. Best of all, it works on any device. There's no better way to completely lock out stalkers or any other hacker from your personal bubble than by using Dashlane. Dashlane goes the extra mile by alerting you if any of your accounts or data are breached. It also has a dark web monitoring system that will immediately let you know if your personal information appears on the dark web, where it can be seen by hackers, spammers, or stalkers. From my experience, Dashlane is the best all bases covered security and time saving tool out there. If you visit my unique promo link in the description, you can get a free premium trial of Dashlane for 30 days. Plus, if you enter 42 at checkout, you'll gain 10% off Dashlane Premium. Thanks for watching, and thanks again to Dashlane for sponsoring this video. Don't forget to check them out using the link below.